Hello everyone, this is Engineer Mayur Chapte. I am a Lean Six Sigma Black Belt Certified from NIQC International Bangalore. I am recording this video because we have participated in DN Business Excellence Award 2020. In the most popular award category. Here we have done a project related to 5S Home, in which we are showcasing our achievements, the steps we have followed to make our home a 5S home. Then the creativity that we have used to beautify our home. Yes. So before starting this presentation, let me tell you, if you really like our work or project or creativity, then please do like, comment and share. The more you like, comment and share, the more are the chances to get award in a popular category. So let's start by the presentation. So this presentation is related to 5S Home. So firstly, let me tell you about 5S. 5S is nothing but a advanced housekeeping, or in other words, we can say it's a common sense approach which leads to improved workplace or management culture. Basically, 5S is invented in Japan. That's why they spell it as Seiri, Siton, Seiso, Siketsu, Shitsuke. These are the five steps of 5S. Sort, set in order, shine, standardize, sustain. So these are the five steps that we need to do in order to achieve 5S home or 5S organization. Other than this five steps, there is one more step called 6S. So 6S is related to safety. Now why they have introduced this 6S? Because safety is the topmost priority in every workplace, as you know. That's why each and every industry, even in house also, we need safety. That's why 6S is being introduced. Now let me tell you the key principle of the 5S. As we discussed earlier, there are main five aspects, and this 6S is the advanced one. So in short, what we do, it's about reorganization the things. We need to sort out wanted and unwanted things. Then set in order. We need to arrange the things as per its requirement. That is place for everything and everything in its place. Then the third step is shine. Shine is nothing but a combination of 1S and 2S. So it's all about cleaning. Then standardize. Once we done sort, set in order and shine, then comes standardize. So standardize is nothing but creating a rule, following a rule to ensure the change is documented and is being followed. So this is about standard. Means here we need to make a standard procedure by which we can follow our sort, set in order and sign steps. Then sustain. Up till now we have done this cleaning, then sorting, but we need to sustain also. So this is the most difficult part in 5S, sustenance. So sustenance is all about discipline, how we practice good habit to sustain the 5S. Then the last one is safety. So safety is related to identifying the hazards and preventive controls. So these are the key principles. So 5S home. So these are the objectives of 5S. Why we should go for 5S home? 5S concept is okay for organization and workplace management, but why at home? So we think these are the objectives for implementing 5S in home. The first one is basically to inculcate self-development, self-discipline, change in habit through workplace management and hygiene concept of 5S. Then the second one, to involve family members to keep their home clean and hygiene. See, by implementing the 5S home, we can build a much better bond with the family members. Here, our creativity will be used in a combined manner. We get to know each other in more better way. We get to know about the creative side of each other. So these are the common objectives to improve ourselves and our family member to get self-discipline, organized lifestyle, of course. Then 5S home is also a best example for our neighbors too. That we'll discuss in later slide, how we are setting the example for our neighborhoods. So as we discussed, first step in 5S is sort. So in sort, we are eliminating the unnecessary thing. Means we are segregating the wanted and unwanted. Why we are doing this? Because if we need any atom and that atom is not placed properly, then it may take a longer time to find that atom. Okay, so for all this, we are doing the 5S. So first step in 5S is sort. This is the first step. So for example, we have done segregating in laptop drawer. So this is first a laptop drawer. We have inspected the drawers. We have segregated it. Likewise, we have done it for a charger drawer inspection. Then the chargers are segregated and we have binded that charger with the help of rubber band, as you can see. Likewise, we have done it for TV table drawer also. Then kitchen. So up till now, in the first step, we saw we need to segregate unwanted and wanted things. Now what's next? So in the next step, we need to prepare a place for everything. For example, as you can see, here are a lot of jars, then the matchbox, then this tray, everything. So we need to have proper place for everything. So the second phase is place for everything, everything in its place. This is set in order. So in set in order, we are creating a place for everything. Likewise, the systematic arrangement. So after inspection of the laptop drawer, we have done a systematic arrangement. Now in this case, if I need a pen, a blue color pen, then I can get that blue color pen easily if we do arrangement like this. In earlier case, it was quite difficult to search a particular pen, a blue color or red color or pencil might be. But now after sorting unwanted and wanted things, now I can get the things very easily. Likewise, this scissor, then stapler, magnifier glass, cutter, everything. So we have done a systematic arrangement. This is a foam sheet, as you can see here. Now this is for a dressing table, a systematic arrangement for dressing table. This concept most of the people I consider should appreciate. In this way, we can arrange our housekeeping items so that it won't get displaced anywhere. And you can find it easily also. You can do this at your home also. So this is a systematic arrangement for housekeeping. This is for kitchen racks, systematic arrangement, kitchen shelves. See, as you can see here, marking system. We have done a marking system, this in green color, so that we get to know when our stock will end and when we need to top up that particular box, a particular, shelf. See, in this way, we can arrange our kitchen shelf. The third step is shine. in Japanese term, it is called seso. This is nothing but a combination of 1s and 2s. In this phase, we need to sweep out our area, a pure cleaning. That's it. Let's see what we have done. As you can see, in our home, we have sweep out our area finely. It is shining, the tiles are shining. So likewise, you can sweep out the area from your home or from your workplace. It will give you a good feeling, a pleasant feeling to be at home, right? Then the fourth step is standardized. It's called as shiketsu in Japanese term. So the fourth step is standardized. In this stage, we need to prepare one checklist. That is okay for this week. I am cleaning, for example, TV drawer, then the dressing table, then the laptop drawer, then kitchen drawer. Likewise, we have to make a checklist, a proper checklist. Likewise, we have done here, as you can see, the TV drawer. So TV drawer inspection is weekly. We have scheduled this is weekly. Dressing table weekly, laptop drawer weekly, kitchen racks is monthly. Likewise, we have made one checklist, a weekly or monthly checklist to clean entire home. Then in standardize, we need to have one standard procedure. Or you can see in this standardized stage, we have nomenclatured the buttons. For example, here you can see F6, C6, T6. So F6 means fan number 6. C6 means CFL number 6. This is tube light number 6. Same nomenclature we have done on the fan also. The CFL bulb, the tube light also. So that your time will be saved. Okay. See, this is CFL. So C1, C2, this is tube light T2. So if you need to switch on the tube light 6, then you can directly press the T6 button. Okay. T3, F3 likewise. So this is CFL, this is F3, this is F6. In this way, you can save your time. This is just an example that at our home, but where there are a number of fans, number of tube lights, and just we need to switch on a particular fan or tube light, then this method will be helpful. So this is in standardized phase. This is our balcony garden. Likewise, we have sorted all the rose flower pots on one side, and height-wise this height-wise plots on other side. So you can arrange as per your choice, all rose flower or purposeful plants, then attractive plants likewise. But anyhow, you need to maintain the standard of procedure. In the fifth stage, sustain is the fifth stage of 5S. In sustain, we need to maintain our 4S. Okay, so here, as we have discussed, we made one checklist for inspection and cleaning weekly and monthly. We need to inspect this as per mentioned duration. Thus, we need to tick, okay, this is done. So you can write here date, okay, weekly. So date 1, date 2, date 3, date 4. Likewise, you can make. So here we have created one checklist and pasted on a wall. Okay, to get work done or to sustain our 5S. This is the most important step, as we have discussed, because see, if you are not maintaining the cleanliness and the things you have done earlier, it is total a waste of time, waste of energy also. So in order to maintain everything, this sustenance is the most important part. Yeah, creativity. to sustain the 5S environment. So these all crafts are made from waste plastic bottle, as you can see. And if you want to see the tutorial, you can go directly on Moiraksham Crafts. You can see the tutorial how we have made this all the craft. This is a waste oil can. These are the distillery bottles. This is again the phenyl bottle. This is the plastic bottle. So in 5S you can be creative as much as possible. You can take help from your family members also, your kids, your wife, your parents. This is also made from all the plastic bottles. These are the waste tires that we can use in this way to decorate our home or workplace, etc. This is the YouTube channel where you can see the tutorial that I have just shown to you. Advantages of 5S. Why we should go for 5S? The first and most important part of 5S at home is bring about family bondage. When we are doing something with your family, then we are creating a bond with your family members. Then sense of pride and ownership. Obviously, when we are decorating our home, if any guest came to our home, then obviously he will praise our creativity or neatness. Then that gives us a sense of pride. Delight to visitor, the same thing. Then searching time minimized. If you need a particular thing and if it is placed properly after in 5S concept, then the searching time will be minimized. Then develop a lifelong quality habit. So these are five basic advantages. There are many advantages of 5S at your home or workplace, but these are the basic advantages you will get by applying 5S concept. Summary. So 5S involves 5S includes involvement of every member, family members. It creates areas of individual ownership. For example, here we can nominate that, for example, okay, bedroom inspection will be done by family member number one. Toys room inspection will be done by your kid. Then likewise, you can distribute the ownership. It will also give a sense of ownership to family members. Then encourage the decluttering philosophy. We need to segregate wanted and unwanted things. Those things we don't want, we can pack them up and put in the shelf. Then, as I have shown to you, this creativity part, we can allow creativity and innovation in implementation. Then we need to develop a checklist for environment and sustenance, because we need to sustain what we have done. So this is all about the 5S part. Thank you for listening patiently. If you really like our work, then please do like, share and comment. Your feedback will be most appreciated. Thank you. Thank you once again.